Hello everyone, and welcome to another video with me, Winter Android. Picking off of where we left off last time, where we went and took over the Philippines and also all of these other islands over here in the Pacific, including Papua New Guinea there. And I forgot to do this in the last episode, which is finishing off all the stuff of Micronesia, considering I didn't expect them to win their war with Fiji. So I have to finish them off, which I can do in the next turn. But I think my target for this episode is going to be Australia and New Zealand. Go after both of them next. Then I think after that I'll probably be going after Indonesia in the next episode or something. So yeah, I'll go ahead and get to work on getting ready for that. Which I think I'm going to need to recruit some more troops for. At the moment, at least. So, let's see. Go to next turn. And quickly deal with Micronesia. There we go. And now I just need to recruit troops. But first I'm going to get through a few turns so I can build up some money to do that. Here we go. Seems the majority of the troops I can recruit are all in Korea. Don't want to recruit troops in Tokyo. There we go. I think that'll be good for now. Now just get all these troops over to here with the rest of them. And that one. That's the one in North Korea, I think. And that's South Korea. Yep. That should be everything there. So now it's just to wait for all the troops to get over here. Put that point into administration costs. Considering I'm expanding now and the administration costs are going to be going up even more. Well, Australia decided to go to war with me instead. Okay. I didn't expect India to go to war with me. Okay. Well, it's nice they already have an army sitting over here ready to invade Australia. At least half of it is over here already. So these troops can go and invade, I guess. Very quickly. Send those troops there while the rest of them will head over to deal with India for now. And that's all the troops, I think. Zimbabwe, no, I am not going to go toward Madagascar with you. Can't I have two attacks over here? What happened to the rest? Oh well. I guess Australia took out the other attack with troops they're sending in that direction. Or something. So, got that invasion going. And I need to think about doing something when it comes to India. But really, I'll be satisfied just getting that off India in this war, I guess. Don't really care about the rest. And over here. Good. Next turn, those troops get there. And now for this group, I guess I'll split them up to do that. And this one will split up as well. Those troops go for Sydney. And now we're here with these troops. Send a group of them to take that group of islands. And the rest go over here trying to take that. not even putting up a fight in this turn. Okay. And then those two goats there. And these troops are basically never going to be seeing any more fighting, I think. But I'll still send them that way to hopefully have them get some more fighting in. Didn't even defend their capital. Got those two. That one goes there, and that one will there, and there. I think that'll be good. Get rid of those two notifications. Now I'll just send all those troops up there, and I'll send these here and build a port in Melbourne over here. There we go. And I'll build a port there as well. Now let's go over here and do this. Now I think I'll need to be sending these troops over here to try and get that, considering I don't think those troops are going to survive. Got all of mainland Australia now. now there is no way I was going to win that with those troops. Take those two islands and I will have Australia finished off. There we go. Now just send these troops here. And take all as much of Australia as I can, because I can't actually take it all. Apparently. Well, that's all I can take there. Put that into administration. And I think those troops got moved. Yep. So I'll just build the ports there and send the troops up there instead. So now I just need to get all those troops so I can try and take this island off of India. And of course, majority of the troops get wiped out in just the attack. That first attack there. Meaning the rest stand absolutely no chance. Great. So now I need to go through and get more troops. I'd like them to be down in Taiwan or the Philippines, considering they're closer. Okay, guess I'll deal with a bit of province stability of all these provinces now. So, now let's get all these troops ready to attack India. Okay, Thailand just went to war with me. And considering I don't really want to deal with them, I'll just get peace with them first. Really, only reason why I'm still fighting Gendia is because I do actually want to see about getting something out of the war since they went to war with me. Well, New Zealand. Sure. India, I'll just take this one province off of you. And I'll just go and send all of these troops to deal with New Zealand instead. Now, where are those troops at? Okay, there they are. You all are going to be staying over here just in case New Zealand tries to take any of Australia from me. And India, of course, rejected that. Because why would they accept it? Those two will head over here to help with New Zealand. Okay. I think I'll go and attack New Zealand already. Send these troops over here to help. Okay. Deal with a bit more of the province stability in Australia before I forget it even more. There we go. All these troops will just head over and attack one province this time instead of splitting them to two. Okay, New Zealand. Sure. Attack the Philippines. While I have your entire southern island under my control now. Also take these troops and send them over here as well. Now, India is being very stubborn there. How in the world did you attack that province? That province doesn't even border. They don't even border each other. Seriously? I think that's a bug I just found. Great. So, got these 5,000 troops here that I'll send in over to try and take their capital. Got all the Philippines back. Now, I'll just group up all these troops here in the Philippines, since I think I'll be sending them to attack India, since they are still putting up a fight. Now I'll see about recruiting as many troops over here as possible as well. Just two provinces left over here to take. And I'll have all of New Zealand. So now I just have to go and deal with all that. Well, I decided to cut the video right there, and, well, it seems the video, at like 28 minutes of video there, was very laggy, and I can't really re-record any of that, considering the last save was on turn 327, and I started the video on turn 102, so, yeah. Sorry for all the lag at the beginning of throughout this video so far, but the rest of this shouldn't be laggy at all, really, since this bit of it is going to be a short piece of the recording. So, let's see about actually finishing off what's left here. More troops there, and now have 44,000 troops there to deal with that. Take all of New Zealand, get these troops over here to fight India. There we go. Province stability and deal with all this, which I just don't have the money to do at all for. Great. So, let's see. Now it's going to take a few turns to get all the money for us, so I'm just going to ignore it for now, since my troops are already over here. Can't really do that much against 44,000 troops now, can ya, India? Now, would you let me have what I want over here? I'll just be happy with that one island group of islands over there. For now, at least. Okay, thank you, India. Now just do that, and I'll be good. For this, now get all those troops off of those islands there, and send them over here because I need to finish off Australia. Which I think I'll be doing in the next episode, considering how long this one already is. Go. So, just let all these troops get over here so I can easily invade Australia at the beginning of the next episode. Into administration as well. There we go. So, yeah. That is where I'll be finishing off this episode. I hope you've all enjoyed this video, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye-bye.